Hello everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to review Shadows of Ivory by T.L. Greylock and Bryce O'Connor. Esca de Caraval, head of the Forensia company, finds herself framed for murder and hunted for the strange bronze disc she has that she definitely didn't steal. Rivals hunt not only her, but the same secrets she's looking for. Esca must defend herself while struggling to prove her innocence, all the while trying to unravel the mysteries in front of her. This is a finalist for the self-published fantasy blog off, round 7. And before I get too much into the review, I just want to point out this cover. It's not nearly as grimdark as you would expect it to be from this sort of cover. And I've got to admit that this is a book that caught my eye quite some time ago because of the cover. So it was on my get to eventually list, and then it became a finalist for the SBFBO and I got to read it. I found this to be much more of an adventure and mystery than skeleton in armour. So Esca de Caraval definitely didn't steal whatever that was. She's cunning and resourceful and really far more interested in archaeology and trying to unravel the mystery than pretty much anything else. She understands that her place can be precarious, but she's willing to fight when she knows that she's right, but she also understands the value of the strategic retreat. I loved her as a character. She's adaptable, open-minded, stubborn almost in her quest for knowledge, and in my character notes one of the main things I highlighted was knows her shit. Manon Barker is really her rival and she knows that Esca is up to something. She really needs to earn some money to regain her family status, so she's perhaps willing to take some risks that are not entirely sensible. There is an absolute air of desperation coming off her chapters at points. It did take me a little bit longer to fall into Manon's chapters, but I really also enjoyed her as a character. Albus, the librarian, is another point of view character, but we do spend a little bit less time with him. He's still decently developed, but he goes off on this incredible journey when he would really rather be just doing some research, I think. And there are an absolute wealth of side characters throughout this who all have something really interesting to add. One of the things I really enjoyed about this was just how much of the world we got to see throughout. Lots of journeys and places to explore, and each place we visited felt distinct from everywhere else, like it had its own personality of this new place. They all had a different feeling and environment. A lot of the history of the world and some of the world building is carried out and given to the reader through interludes from the main chapters. These are documents, articles, letters that give important information about what's going on without the characters having to resort to, as you well know, conversations throughout the text. They are something that you do need to pay attention to because there is a lot of information that becomes relevant later on. I did enjoy this because the documents created did actually feel like proper in-world information. They felt like they had been lifted from the place we were visiting. There is a very intriguing magic system and I'm really looking forward to getting deeper into this one. There is a lot of information given in the interludes about why users of this magic would hold it so close to their chest and not announce that they are able to use magic. People in this world are known as carriers who have the ability to use fire or water. It's their affinity. Now, there may be others. We don't really know a lot of details and not very good things have happened to them in the past. One of the things I did notice was just how smooth and easy to get into the writing was. When I came back to the book after a break, it was just so easy to slide straight back into the world and 80, 100 pages would go by so very quickly. The style is absorbing without being overwhelming. The pacing to me felt a little bit up and down. We had a very fast start, there was a lot going on, and then it lulled a little bit more in the middle as we obviously built up more towards the events that needed to happen towards the end of the book. I'm not saying a book has to be fast-paced all the way through, but it was fairly noticeable that the middle sections took me a lot longer to get through than the start and the end. Another thing I did want to point out was that the end of the book to me didn't actually feel like the end. It felt like I could just turn the page and there would be another chapter, but the book stops. It didn't quite feel like a conclusion in its own right. I did really enjoy the adventure, and I'm so looking forward to finding out some more of the mysteries in the next book. For the SBFBO, I have rated this at 7.5. So if you have read this, I would love to know your thoughts. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you all soon.